The Tonight Show and The Tomorrow Show will each begin one half hour later than usual, so that we may bring you the following NBC News special report.
James Warren Jones, better known as Father Jim Jones. To some, he was a powerful and spiritual leader and a good and thoughtful man. At various times, he said he was the reincarnation of Jesus Christ and Vladimir Lenin.
NBC News reports Jonestown, November 1978. How could it happen? Here is NBC News correspondent Edwin Newman.
Good evening, I'm Edwin Newman. It has now been 4 days since five Americans were shot dead by other Americans on the airstrip of Port Kaituma in Guyana. Among the dead was Representative Leo Ryan of California. They had gone to investigate a cult called the People's Temple, headed by a man known as Reverend Jim Jones, and they were to be killed by members of this cult. As appalling as it was, it did not prepare us for what followed.
Over 500 suicides and killings here in the jungle commune at Jonestown. All these men, women, and even children who believed in Jim Jones and everything he said took their own lives by way of self-induced poisoning. So this is what the People's Temple's grand plan unfortunately came to. Mass suicide by cyanide-laced punch and bullets. People being pushed and possibly forced into positions where they welcome their own deaths as a means to an end. Even when they know it's so.
Leo Ryan to go to Jonestown in the first place was an appeal from a friend whose son, daughter, and even grandchildren were all members of the People's Temple cult.
This is what life was like here in Jonestown during Congressman Ryan's investigation. The camp was set in a rainforest, cleared and cultivated by members of the People's Temple. Jonestown looked like many communes, a place where people of different races and walks of life could live in simple dwellings and work together.
You see, before I experienced eating that bucket of KFC, before I experienced eating that bucket of KFC chicken, it was about the 11 herbs and spices, yeah. Before I had my bucket of KFC 11 herbs and spices chicken,
Today, there have been these developments. The first batch of 500 that were stewed about the People's Temple Village began to be identified, and the search continues for members of the cult that fled into the South American jungle rather than commit suicide.
This is what Jonestown looked like live yesterday when U.S. airmen arrived there. Bodies still lay there since the morning as the airmen wander around completely stunned at the sight of what happened a few days prior. NBC and the news production team had met and spoke with some of the People's Temple members days before the massacre during Congressman Ryan's investigation. Here is what they had to say about what it was like to live here in the Jonestown Village.
Are you happy here?
Oh, I should say I am. I've never been any happier in my life.
You want to stay?
Definitely. I certainly do.
And you girls, what about you?
I love staying here. I'm getting trained in obstetrics. I'm laboratory technician. I found my work here very fulfilling. I love it here. I like this place much better. I won't want to go back there. I like it now. I just like to be here with the rest of my friends and stuff.
During Congressman Ryan's investigation, the followers of Reverend Jones demonstrated their fervent support of their leader at a reception for the congressman and his delegation.
Glad to be here. This is a congressional inquiry. I think that all of you know that I'm here to find out more about questions that have been raised about your operation here. But I can tell you right now that from a few conversations I've had with some of the folks here already this evening, that whatever the comments are, there are some people here who believe that this is the best thing that ever happened in their whole life.
Many of the people you see here cheering are now dead. Now, we don't know exactly which ones, but we do know that of the over 500 corpses that have been found, more than 80 were children.
Oh boy, chicken. I'm really not, this chicken is pretty, this KFC chicken, let me get a really good taste of it. I don't even know if I really wanted KFC.
There for the moment the story stands as the investigation is still ongoing. The massacre has unfortunately provoked many comments at the horrible events in Guyana were a reflection of American society. TASS, the Soviet news agency, calls what happened at Jonestown a symptom of an inhumane society. Some of the countries that are now freely commenting have had horrors of their own to answer for, but there's not much comfort in that. This was American cultism. This was Americans killing other Americans and themselves. In its own interest, for its own well-being, this nation will have to find out why. I'm Edwin Newman, NBC News.
This has been a special report from NBC News.
This is the NBC Television Network.